picking it? Why should we pick it? But the real talk is that Mag is OP.
He is.
You have Bloodlust, right? I mean, ogres are very common heroes. I think Bloodlust...
Fear can, but none other in this game.
How are you, Andy?
Well, it's gonna be... Oh, Universe in a lot of trouble. Perfect Chainsaw, easiest first blood.
Even the RNG rune is there. Yeah, until this new item.
Alright. PPD looks like he's gonna get a little bit dope. Oh, the call down. PPD and the LSA.
Oh my god.
Just wrecked under the tower there.
Jesus, that ain't... how unfun is that?
Alright, alright. Just saying.
Viper can turn on fun. Oh! Fear!
Oh, Fear no!
Fear's ripped, but he does actually land one. Push him back. You know, it's not easy, but he lands it. They get one kill and looking for a second. There's a coil and confirm Fear landing RP and winning the game.
Boom. Get wrecked.
What did we say?
What did we say?
Waga? What did...
Probably more likely to be just the Empower and buffed up Vengeful.
Yeah.
Helping the Terrorblade to carry this game, but I mean, I still think he's gonna struggle.
Assuming that your supports are doing enough job. Oh, good skewer. Echo Slam's gonna come through that. DK Fobo is very tanky, but where's the Chrono? It comes in just a second tad late. Fear's gonna get burned down here. Max dropping pretty low as well. They're gonna focus on PPD. They get a kill very quickly, and keep in mind that...
Void does go down though, so
he has his ultimate, and he'll use it right then and there. But the burst damage is there. They bring him just as low. They burst him down quick. Meanwhile, Universe trying to juke left and juke right. Silence and the right click, but there's Spike Steel.
You cannot battle 21 armor on Shirley Finette.
He is trying to do a little bit of D ward. The magic stick actually brings him up high a lot, and that RP was real. Three-man RP brings him back. The coil is there. The fissure is there. Look, man. I'm gonna just say Mech might have helped, but everybody's dead.
As well. Yeah.
So it makes Fear's job a lot easier in that case too.
He has Blink and Force Staff now.
Yeah.
They're going behind here, want to catch anyone, but everyone is so elusive. Either the puck, or they're going on Fear with that ward FNG dropped.
Yep, and the Chainsun is there. Fear is gonna be dead, and Coil does actually land on Universe Silence 2 as well. Here comes Bernardo Reyes. The dunk is here. He gets one. The Lugina ability gets dropped down. He's trying to do as much damage as possible before
Arteezy
he drops.
Getting targeted down.
Offensive Urn as well. The long range of the Sunder is gonna fly through the swap offensively, and DK Fobo is very tanky, but the damage is there.
I think Zai might live here. Oh wow. My god, how?
Massive win. Massive win. Just beautiful execution. Pretty deep commitment to dive in for that Magnus there. Monster.
Okay, everything on Juan Fernandez. Give him the Laguna Blade.
He's fluttering.
He's gonna bait stuff out.
Ooh, actually, the skewer missed. A rare miss, and here comes a Chrono. That's up to four, and the flag is real. PPD dead.
Jesus.
All right, Arteezy's the only one alive, and the chain stun is there. You know what? The Balls of Steel was there for Shirley from that, but Mag.
It's goal time.
All right, what a comeback.
They're saying that there's not a game like that right now, Lumi.
This is that game.
Right.
We're just at the very start of it.
Oh, bottom.
Okay. It looks like the Mag got picked up. The double user coming out. We need to BKB. They jump back here.
The man down.
Looks
jump
like
away.
FNG is going to get picked up. FNG does have buyback. Not the biggest loss. And actually, PPD is going to be able to. Meanwhile, backdoor's up on top. Fear drops the first RP. Echo's going to miss. They're going to focus everything on Mag. The second RP is going to come out. They throw everything on Mag. They get him dead. He's forced to buy out right now. And Universe could be giving some chase. Tier 3 has been destroyed up top. Tier 3 has been destroyed mid. And they're going to focus on the Terra Blade. The Chainsaw's got to be there. And they bring him down. No cheese, no Aegis, nothing. He's got buyback, and he might. Chrono hits on three. This could be the game.
And they see Magnus now. Okay. How? They see them down there. Are they gonna turn?
How quick is the hex on Universe?
Godfingers.
Godfingers. Oh, they see Fear. Fear's gonna get blown up. Chrono's gonna get used, and that acceptor is really big in terms of the low cooldown.
Oh,
they find
PPD
as well. PPD. He doesn't have the force staff.
They have to defend as well. Terrorblade going for the base. Kill this fast and get out.
Okay, they got a BLT back right now. The tier 3s are being sieged. Where is the gyrocopter?
Yeah, he doesn't have... I don't know why he wouldn't travel there.
Arteezy says, I'm gonna suicide for the Rax, and he's gonna go top right there. He gets one, he gets two.
It's too late.
I don't think he's even suiciding for anything. He just walks away because the TP back to base is not quick enough.
Roche is back like, oh god, why hasn't the game ended?
This is the fifth Roche, I believe. Oh, looks like we have a jump initiation on top. LSA will land, they will use a Chrono and the BKB for that. There's a refresher orb on Mag, so he is, wow, look at how
long.
Autumn
Swap goes down.
Okay, they're gonna focus on DK Phobos, but he's very, very tanky. In fact, here comes the gyrocopter. He's gonna force everybody away. Meanwhile, mid is being sieged in.
Refresher doing work.
Okay, Chrono's gonna actually go on Juan Fernandez. Can he get off the Sunder? He's trying, he gets bashed. Surely Fernandez.
Yeah, you can take it instead of the
Surely they find Universe. It's the real one, the multicast. It's the ding, the ding. There's no follow up. The Yule Scepter's gonna bring himself up the Chrono to get Universe. Maybe forget about Roche. Maybe just keep going.
Oh, careful, RP. This is a dangerous ramp to walk up.
Nearby as well. Oh, they find PPD as well.
Very
Maybe
nice.
The bench will just die. PPD's gonna get Laguna. He rips too.
He bites back.
Okay, he bites back.
Universe 2.
All right, what are they gonna do? BKB's gonna get activated. Oh, he jumps away. No problem. Yeah.
The jump away is fine. Little Hardy might go down here.
He force staff him in, and it's gonna get focused. A big angle. The RP does it, but surely Fernandez is still hitting. The defensive swap is gonna be there. Juan swaps on Universe. Universe says, "What are you doing?" But he's right clicking right now, and he's right clicking really hard. The Lincoln is broken, but there's no flag. He gets fissured. Does he have Satanic? I don't think
he
does.
No, he doesn't. He doesn't even have a life steal right now.
Surely Fnet triple buyback from his team. We need the mag secondary RP. He's right clicking. Surely Fnet kills Juan, and surely Fnet is still flacking away. Meanwhile, the distraction is running. Top is slowly pushing in. Bernardo Reyes, he's dead. Puck is trying to run around. He needs to blink. He'll blink away. He gets hit.
He gets punched.
Okay, he'll back out. But look at top. Look at mid. Everything is pushing. They got to defend for now.
Yeah, they have to. Viper is also dead without buyback, which is a big thing. Little Hardy being chased by Universe, but no damage really being...
There's Chrono, but there's also Swap. That's kind of the big deal here.
They should go before the RP is up.
All right, here comes the Chrono, the Swap. Where's the real one?
This is really good.
He doesn't need a Swap right now. He will Swap after the focus goes on. Shirley actually walks into the Chrono. Now the BKB comes up with the secondary Chrono. There's no more Swap. Shirley's right-clicking. Juan, can he Sunder it? There's nothing. There's no Sunder. He's dead. He's dead for 2 minutes.
2 minutes. Yeah,
Literally 9 mines.
I think they should back out almost because this is too easy for EG to win this fight. But they gotta keep going.
Three men and four men.
I can get it back. They got it back. No,
they cannot do this, I think.
Just go back. Just go back. The Echo's gonna be there. They got Chrono, but you cannot Chrono just a Shaker. Shaker, though, he's losing so much health. Universe just dies to the flag. RP's gonna be there. That's all the Chrono. And Shirley Fnet has to dance around the Chrono. The Swap's gonna be there. There's no damage for Juan. The secondary Chrono. There, everybody needs to go back. Surely, though, he is not going back. He's got the Lincolns.
Oh,
he's getting critted. He does not have buyback. He dies. No more buyback.
And
is this GG? Two divines gets dropped. I think they should have backed.
Yeah.
That's it. Right, you know.
All right, I think that would make me mad. You know.
All right.
You'd buy back for that, to defend the effigy.
I would defend my effigy.
Oh, the heal's gonna be there. He jumps away from the RP. RP gets him back out. The defensive swap is there as well. Where is the gyrocopter in all of this? The team has initiated way too soon. He's gonna try to port in, but the creep gets killed. Earthshaker comes in the right time, and everything is dead.
Yeah, and that's gonna be
that's
the end of it.
That's a poor fight from BP Polar.
Surely Fnet, the only one left to see his base die.
And
GG, well played, gets called.
I think that was a very winnable game for VP Polar at certain points.
I mean, at the end of it, there were so many things already to think about. It's easy for us to say that, you know, use your Lincolns, give back the Divine, and maybe you could have won.
Right.
But
yeah.
Overall, they already had so many things to consider, the refreshers, the combos, and, you know, kudos to VP Polar for a really strong performance in this game. And also, kudos to EG's discipline this game. They don't care about you.